Ladies and gentlemen, Mike, Third Street Barbell. Today we're going to talk about the belt squat, how you apply it, how you use it, and maybe some varied exercises that'll help you make some extra gains. Obviously, the belt squat has gotten a lot of popularity over the last couple years. They're more easily available from multiple companies here at Third Street. We decided to go with Rogues. I've used many on the market, and no, not sponsored, nothing like that, but it's the one I preferred for the feel, how it sits, usability, and then also I've read and I've felt that the poundage that you're squatting on there is closest to 1-to-1. It feels really good. The rails empty are like 30, 40 pounds, but each pound on there feels very similar to something you would squat or pull over there. The number one function, obviously, is squatting with a belt on. So you use a specialized belt for it that is like kind of like a lifting belt, and it's ways that you can get a lot of lower body volume, work on your hamstrings, your glutes, your quads. We'll show you a calf exercise as well, but with taking the upper body out of it and taking your spine out of it, if you're feeling a little beat up from your shoulders, your elbows, your wrists, maybe it's an injury, or you're trying to get extra volume without holding the barbell on your back, this is a great option. The other greatest option, maybe people don't talk about as much, is if you're not a barbell athlete. Not everyone has to train with the barbell. I think it's one of the best tools to build strength. I love powerlifting, weightlifting, strongman. But if you're another athlete, or you're just trying to build some muscle, feel a little bit better, get a little bit stronger, or you play team sports, this is one of the best tools you can utilize in your belt. So let's dive in. All right, so Rogues in particular comes with their own belt, but you can use a lot of different belts with it. You can kind of jerry-rig a lot of the different variations. You kind of just need a carabiner and some type of belt and maybe a chain. This one in particular is super easy because it already has different, I don't want to be scratching my chin. It already has different levels involved. So you just grab the carabiner on there, you clip it on equal sides, whatever one fits your height best. I'm a short guy, so we're gonna go way up here on like number three. Oh, I'm on number four. Then you're just gonna place the belt whatever's most comfortable. I got a little bit of a dumper, as people would say, so I put it right on my low back. It actually feels kind of good. Gets a little traction back there. But however the belt's gonna stay, it's just gonna kind of wrap around your hips. Simply gonna squat. Each belt squat is slightly different, but the safeties on this one, you just pull towards you, and you can use these. If you wanna overload, you can kind of use them for leverage, but if you're really trying to focus on your legs, I suggest trying to use maybe the back of your palm or something different, so you're just using it for balance and you're not using it to move the weight. Then grab your stance. Obviously starting, you should probably just start with your regular squat stance. You're gonna squat down, squat right back up. Majority of these squat belt squats have large platforms, so you can kind of change up your squat. If you're not comfortable with a wider squat stance with a barbell on your back, this is a great option to get some of those muscles involved, maybe work on some mobility under load. I'm not a huge mobility or foam roll guy, but I think this is a better option where you can use a load, you can be under control with these handles, and you can get a nice wide. Maybe you're using your sumo stance, you really get your quads involved, end up in your starting sumo position, fire up. A little bit closer stance, knees going forward, a little bit more quad dominant, going a little bit wider, get a little bit more of your posterior. When you're done, you simply just push this forward, lock it into place. So you can adjust the handles as well, depending on your height. You simply just pull this guy out, there's a safety lock over here, pull it out, go up and down. Majority of people will be able to use the same handle height, in my opinion, because it's kind of a circular here, you can just grab different points. The belt is the bigger piece. The belt, you'll have to adjust a little bit more or a little bit less, depending on your height. And then the safety is the last one. We have it somewhere near the top and we kind of keep it there. It works for most, but if you're having trouble getting in or out of the belt with tension, you can go ahead and pull this out and it will change where the safety sits on the railing. We're gonna show you guys some of our favorite accessories that we do with this thing. Again, this is just a carabiner, so you can kind of finagle things and add anything you want onto there. I'm just gonna add a simple curl bar. One of my second favorite exercises is like an RDL. You can do rows, upright rows, and a bunch of different exercises. It feels really, really smooth. If you're not a Third Street Barbell member and you don't have access to this beautiful cable machine, and this is your only cable apparatus, it can be a little bit more versatile. You can do some curls and other things on there. But one of my favorite for sure is an RDL. So you're gonna pull this guy up. Hopefully you'd have a teammate. My teammate is Jim McDee and he's behind the camera. So I gotta do it all my gosh darn self. And now you get a full range of motion. All you do is focus on a little bit of a soft knee. I'm gonna push my hips way back as flat as I can. Allow this thing to drag me forward. Really feel a stretch in the hammy, and I'm gonna squeeze my glutes all the way through. For all my folks out there really trying to join the thick gang, really get involved with your peach status, this is a great accessory for that. Feels really, really smooth, and then you can load it up nice and heavy quite safely. Again, you can use it for multitude of things if you really want to curl on it. It's possible if you have no access to any other cable. Another easy piece that I don't do, but I probably should do, and you can do if you care, is a little bit of a calf raise. So same idea, you're gonna belt this thing in, whatever's comfy, load up some poundages, slowly work your way up, pull this thing at you, and you're in a perfect spot to do a little bit of a donkey calf raise. Nice stretch at the bottom, really allow that reflex to disappear, and squeeze all the way to the top. Perfect with this lip down here, super comfy on your low back. You can load it up real safe with zero hassle. You literally just don't need a calf raise machines. I know it's popular to begin your biceps going, but a dear friend of mine that I've never met before once said, arm days, big arms, sell tickets, big legs, wins games. If you want some power, if you're an athlete, a power lifter, weight lifter, no matter what, strong legs will never let you down. That's the belt squat, Third Street Barbell. I'm Mike.